When you launch the Teams app, you will arrive at your Teams dashboard. We like to think of the Teams dashboard as having two distinct areas, the Me space and the We space. The large area that shows one specific team or all of your teams is the We space because it is where you share, post, and communicate with other members of your teams. The bar on the left-hand side of the screen is where you find notifications about your recent activity, private chats, teams, assignments, meetings, files, and apps. We like to think of this navigation bar as the Me space because it has controls and notifications specifically for you. The center of your screen will contain white boxes with icons. Each of these represents a team to which you belong. You have many choices to control features of your teams, including the option to hide them. Select the ellipses and a drop-down menu will appear. Hidden teams are still active. To see them, scroll down to the bottom of your dashboard and select the downward caret by the Hidden Teams icon. You can always rearrange your team's tiles by simply dragging and dropping. You can even filter your team to show the type you want to view. When you select the filter icon, a list allows you to select all, classes, PLC, or staff teams. To enter a team, select the team tile of the one you want. On the left is a list of channels that are part of this team. Channels are a way to divide up different aspects of your team into categories, units, topics, or themes. Across the top of any team is a row of tabbed features. All teams have chat, files, and a OneNote notebook. The plus sign allows you to add even more apps as a tab. If you want to search for anything in any of your teams, type a name or keyword in the search bar. Need extra help? Microsoft Teams has you covered. There is always a help button at the bottom of your Teams screen.